can't touch this. You can't touch this. Can't touch this. My music hit so hard, makes me say, oh my Lord, thank you for blessing me. What am I to ride and to hike? You feel good when you know you're down. People go all the way from the Oak Town, and I'm known as such. And this is you can't touch. I told you, homeboy, you can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living, and you know you can't touch this. Look in my eyes, man, you can't touch this. Yo, let me bust the funky lyrics. Fresh new kicks and bands. You got it like that. Now you know you wanna dance. So move out of your seat and get a fire girl and catch this beat while it's rolling. Hold on, pump a little bit and let the noise go on like that. Like that. Pull a little bit, just don't fall on back. Let them know that you're too much. And this is a beat they can't touch. Yo, I told you, you can't touch this. Why you standing there, man? You can't touch this. Yo, sound the bell. School is in, sucker. You can't touch this. Give me a song, a rhythm, making them sweat. That's what I'm giving them now. They know. You're talking about the hammer. You're talking about a show that's hyped and tight. Singles are sweating so fast, them a white or a tape. To learn what it's gonna take in the 90s to burn the charts. Legit. Either work hard. All
Go! George Langevin Productions presents CIF Championship Soccer. Hi, this is Joe Naiman, and welcome to Torrey Pines High School, side of the CIF Division I Boys Soccer Championship. The two teams today are Patrick Henry High School and Mira Mesa High School. Patrick Henry's in the green. They'll be starting the game, kicking the ball as soon as the referee blows his whistle. Right there. Mira Mesa's in the white. Two Eastern League rivals who have carried their rivalry beyond the Eastern League title. Now they're going for the whole thing. Our starters tonight for Patrick Henry, our goalkeeper is Kyle Stevens. There is number 20, Mark Foster from Mira Mesa, who just took the ball. Little threat, but there's Kyle Stevens right there. No, that's not Kyle Stevens, that's Josh Quinn, the Mira Mesa goalkeeper. Stevens is on the other end. That is Michael Grimes from Mira Mesa. Passes to Daryl Owen. Owen to Bronco Matic. And that header by Jason Morrison to the sidelines. Taken by Mark Foster. Tries to take it in. We have an injury. But it looks like everything's all right. We're just into the game. Little more than a minute elapsed. And every time a player walks out the field, or yellow card is being issued to Lee Martin of Patrick Henry for the flagrant foul in the referee's terms. So, direct kick to be taken by John Matic. John is the only freshman on either team. He's the younger brother of Bronco. Good defensive play by the Patrick Henry defense. And we'll talk a little bit more about them in a second. That's a long shot by Jason Algy. And that was Kyle Stevens, the Patrick Henry goalie, who just saw kick it downfield. Foul called against Mira Mesa. Henry to retain possession. Kevin Krasno to, no, not Kevin Krasno. Lee Martin to take the kick. And it's headed by Vince Ferracci, but it goes back to Mira Mesa. That's Joey Pellegrino taking it downfield, tries to pass it to Jason Ruffs. Ruffs has the ball from the left side, tries to take it into Pellegrino, it's blocked. Tries once again to Pellegrino, Pellegrino has it, trying to beat his defenders. Foul called on Mira Mesa. Direct kick back to the goalkeeper, Stevens. Stevens' defenders tonight are Jason Larios, a senior, Dustin Jenks, a senior, Diego D'Agostino, the junior, and Derek Adelot, a senior. Patrick Henry has 10 seniors on the team. For them, this is their last chance to win a championship. Mira Mesa has 8 seniors. So there's a lot of experience tonight, a lot of last chances. There's Joey Pellegrino. It's taken away by Juan Larios. Now down the sidelines, Jason Morrison can't get it. But it's still Mira Mesa's ball, Morrison to take the throw in. Down the sidelines, tries to find Mark Foster. Goes out of bounds. The midfielders for Patrick Henry tonight are Peyton Leek, a senior, Lee Martin, a senior, Matt Vega, a senior, and Kevin Krasnow, sophomore. That Krasnow is the only sophomore on the Patrick Henry squad. Patrick Henry's forwards are Peter Tomzovic, a senior, Vince Ferracci, a junior. So Henry is playing with two forwards, hoping to generate some offense with their midfield. There is Peter Tomzovic trying to take it down the sidelines, but out of bounds. Throw in. Daryl Owen to Bronco Matic. Matic gets it to Morrison, to Michael Grimes. Picked away by Patrick Henry into the Mira Mesa defense.
Switch again. Switch it.
There's Josh Quinn, the goalie. Josh Quinn is a junior. And we'll have the Mira Mesa Stars for you in just a second. There's Lee Martin of Patrick Henry with the ball. Martin to the sidelines, finds Vince Ferracci, but out of bounds. The defenders for Mira Mesa are Jason Algy, a junior, Daryl Owen, a senior, and Bronco Matic, a senior.
Move it, let's give him a target.
There's Daryl Owen with the throw in.
Check two, one of you.
Down the sidelines, but headed away by Peyton Leek. Tomzovic tries to find Krasnow. Krasnow and Dudley going for the ball, and Mira Mesa's gonna emerge with possession. The defenders for Mira Mesa are Jason Morrison and Michael Grimes, both juniors. James Dudley, a senior, and Joey Pellegrino, a sophomore. The forwards for the Marauders are Jason Roofs, a sophomore, and John Matic, a freshman, and Mark Foster, a senior. So, not a lot of high school experience up front, but these two teams have played each other twice during the regular season. There's Mark Foster, and unsuccessful. Foster had Pellegrino in the goal mouth, but it was taken away. Possession to Patrick Henry. Patrick Henry is trying for its 20th win tonight. Mira Mesa has already reached the 20-win column. They had a 21-2 regular season record, plus their two wins in the playoffs.
One guy up.
Not quite to midfield, but headed by Peyton Leek. That's a header by Matt Vega of Patrick Henry. And Mark Foster fighting for the ball. It's going to be taken away. Juan Larios of Patrick Henry with the steal. Now to Michael Grimes. Grimes to Pellegrino. And that shot is scored! Jason Algy from the left side takes approximately a 30-yard shot. Mira Mesa leads 1-0, 6 minutes and 46 seconds into the game. So from about 30 yards out, long shot by the defender, Jason Algy, goes in. It's Mira Mesa 1, Patrick Henry nothing, and there's the equalizer! Header by Peyton Leek. It's now 1-1. This score at 7 minutes and 16 seconds, less than a minute. So it's now Mira Mesa 1, Patrick Henry 1. two quick goals early in the first half. And they're threatening again. Peter Tomsevic shoots. Blocked by Josh Quinn. Over the net, corner kick. Nobody gets a break in this game. These are two championship teams. They will not let down. They will not let up. They will not give their opponents a chance to break the game open. Corner kick, Lee Martin. Save, Josh Quinn. These two teams have played each other twice before. Patrick Henry won the first game. Amir Mesa won the first game against Patrick Henry, 1-0. Amir Mesa and Patrick Henry tied in the second game. The league records of these two teams are 7-0-1 for Amir Mesa and 6-1-1 for Patrick Henry. So the tie and for Patrick Henry, the loss, the only blemish on the league schedule. There's a shot attempt by Jason Ruffs. Saved by Kyle Stevens. Both goalies getting a lot of action. Both defensive squads getting a lot of action. There are two substitutes on the sidelines for Patrick Henry warming up already. This is a fast-paced game. It's in stark contrast to the girls' game tonight where the two teams were scoreless in the first half. In the girls' Division I game, San Diego and Bonita Vista held each other scoreless in the first half. In the middle of the second half, San Diego scored. They scored two more in the second half to win 3-0. But already, each team has one goal tonight in the first half. In fact, in the first 8 minutes of the first half, each team has scored. We haven't even reached 10 minutes of the first half yet. We've already seen a lot of action. There is Jason Algy, another long shot attempt, headed away by Justin Jenks to the goalie. Jenks has to be careful. Was on this very field that a CIF championship was won on an own goal back in 1988. In sudden death overtime, nonetheless. There's Algy. That's Derek Adelot, who took the ball away for Patrick Henry. Throw in, Mira Mesa. To be taken by Algy. Tries to find Mark Foster, Foster has it. Tries to cross to Pellegrino. Pellegrino shoots. It's blocked by Stevens. Body blocked by Kyle Stevens. Now on the rebound, Daryl Owen. Header and hits the top of the net. Top of the goal. Header by Foster. And a kick over the net by Pellegrino. Still 1-1. But the way these two teams have been playing, that score might not hold up for long.
Good job, guys. Keep attacking. Let's go.
Goal kick, Patrick Henry. And it's headed in the midfield by Mira Mesa's Branko Matic. And Foster trying to get the ball. Now Jason Grimes from Mira Mesa. It's taken away by Vince Ferracci of Henry. Foul call against Mira Mesa. Free kick for the Patriots.
Hey, White, hold him tight.
Lee Martin to take the free kick.
Stay with the man.
It's been a long time since any Eastern League team was in the finals of the CIF championship, and now we have two.
Up we go.
Kicked away by Branko Matic. And we've seen several headers in a row. Tall midfield generally tonight. We have a few short players. We've seen a lot of long passes in the air tonight. There's Algy, another long pass headed away. centers to Jason Ruffs. Foul call against Patrick Henry. Mira Mesa will have a free kick. Patrick Henry is coached by Don Schaefer. Mira Mesa is coached by Pat Kaur. Kick taken by Algie, shoots for the corner of the net, and just misses. Goal kick by Patrick Henry. It goes back into the Henry side. Throw in by Diego D'Agostino. It's headed away by Jason Grimes. Patrick Henry will have another throw in. D'Agostino once again. A lot of players along the sidelines. And intended for Farachi, taken away by Daryl Owen. Now Patrick Henry has possession, and Mira Mesa takes it away. There's Pellegrino down the sidelines. Tried to find James Dudley. There's Algie. Algie with the goal, with the first goal. Peyton Leak has the goal for Patrick Henry. There's Jason Morrison. Down the sidelines, trying to turn it. And it's going to go to Kyle Stevens. Stevens and backup goalie Danny Templeman are both seniors. Later in the game, we'll have the entire team rosters for you. Free kick to be taken by Patrick Henry. Dustin Jenks has the ball. He's placing it for his free kick. No fakes here. He's almost surely going to take it.
Shooting four, shooting four.
And he will. And Matt Vega tried to bring it in. Didn't quite put his foot on the ball. It was taken away by Josh Quinn. Now Foster. He has triple coverage. And Patrick Henry has the ball. Battle for the ball. It's taken by Daryl Owen. Now it's taken away by Peter Tomzevic. Mira Mesa, Foster has the ball once again. Down the center. Tries to find Ruffs. Ruffs going for the ball. He will not get it. But a corner kick. No, a goal kick. Goal kick to Patrick Henry. Field is a bit moist tonight. It has not rained since Monday. There's a free kick. Mira Mesa will have Algie take the free kick. Now to Pellegrino. Pellegrino in the center, shoots, blocked. Kicked away by Dustin Jenks. And now cleared by Juan Larios. Mira Mesa is going to take it back to the goalie.
Stay free, Bronco.
It's rained a lot in the past week. This game was originally scheduled for Saturday. Looks like I might not get a lot of commentary in. Doesn't seem to be much break in the action. But this game was scheduled for Saturday. That game was rained out. Was rescheduled for Monday. That game was postponed because of rain. So now we're playing Thursday night. Throw in to Bronco Matic. There's Joey Pellegrino. Tries to find Bronco Matic. And there is James Dudley. It's taken away by Patrick Henry, but recovered by Mira Mesa. Al G to Pellegrino. Into the net, off the right side and into the net. At 17:54, it's Mira Mesa 2, Patrick Henry 1. Took the girls tonight 73 minutes to score 3 goals. It took the girls 58 minutes to score just 1 goal, but the boys have scored 3 goals in 17 minutes and 54 seconds. Patrick Henry will try to come back. There is Peter Tomzovic. He is not successful, but a direct kick is awarded to Patrick Henry. They once again have possession. A throw-in has been awarded to Patrick Henry. D'Agostino with the throw-in. Paid away, and it goes back to Patrick Henry to Peyton Leek. Leek. And it goes off Bill DeCora. We're back in action. Patrick Henry once again threatening. They need to tie it up now. Score is Mira Mesa 2, Patrick Henry 1. That's exactly how many goals these two teams scored in the two games they faced each other in the regular season. And because each team won all its other league games, Mira Mesa is the Eastern League champion this year, and Patrick Henry is the runner-up. Sarah and Morrison Kearney also in the Eastern League. Mira Mesa has an active cheerleading section. They're on the same side as the broadcast booth. There is Patrick Henry with the ball and kicked away by Jason Morrison. There's the goalie, Kyle Stevens. Long kick. Can he reach Peyton Leek? No, he can't. It's headed away by Algie. And now Michael Grimes has the ball to Jason Ruff, to Pellegrino, to Foster, blocked by Kyle Stevens. This is definitely an offensive game. No knock on the defense, but these two teams are out for goals. In the regular season, Mira Mesa only gave up 2 goals in a game once. They won 3-2 against Southwest. In the playoffs, they have only allowed 1 goal to Poway in the semifinals. Patrick Henry also has an impressive playoff record. They've already beat 2 seeded teams. Now they're facing the number 2 team in Division 1. They've already knocked off San Diego, who's the top team in Division 1, top seeded team. San Diego had been CIF champions or co-champions for the past 3 years. So Patrick Henry's a tough team, and Mira Mace is a tough team. There is Grimes to Morrison. It's kicked away. Throw in. Grimes to take the throw in. A lot of white shirts near the goal. It will be a long throw in, headed by Foster and blocked by Stevens. Now Owen and Jason Algy with the ball. And there's Michael Grimes, tries to keep it in Mira Mace's feet, and he does. Morrison along the sidelines will keep the ball in bounds, will center it, but. And a foul is called against Patrick Henry. So possession will be retained by Mira Mesa. Matic with the free kick. And refs back to Matic. Refs trying for it. He will not get it, but Daryl Owen will. And Grimes has the ball now. Grimes to Foster. It's taken away by Diego D'Agostino.
Back him up.
Long kick, but to Mira Mesa. Owen. Gets it off to Branko Matic. And foul called against Mira Mesa. Patrick Henry free kick just over the midfield line. Dustin Jenks to take the kick. One Patrick Henry player on the left side, most of them on the right side. It will go to the right side, but it's punched out by Josh Quinn. Blocked by Quinn, goes out of bounds, throw in Patrick Henry. Tomzevic to take the throw in. It's headed away, but Bill DeCorus is there. And that is Ross Murray, who shoots it over the net. Murray and DeCorus are substitutes. The non-stars on the Patrick Henry roster include senior goalkeeper Danny Templeman, junior defender Darren Fionda, junior defender Mike Gentile, sophomore midfielder Anthony Ferracci, sophomore midfielder Kevin Toth, and we see some substitutes for Mira Mesa coming in now. Travis Northcote and Mark Fuller are in for Mira Mesa. Coming out are Michael Grimes and Jason Ruffs. We have a player down. Don Schaefer is out on the field. And there is Murray walking off under his own power. He'll be out for a while. He's being attended to on the Patrick Henry bench. Goal kick. Possession, Mira Mesa. And the sidelines. And that is Kevin Toth, who just came in for Patrick Henry. Kevin is a sophomore midfielder. He is not the son of Zoltan Toth, for those of you who may have been wondering. Zoltan Toth, of course, the former soccer's goalkeeper. And Kevin Toth, the Patrick Henry midfielder.
Stay on the man!
And no, Coach John Schaefer is not the governor of Maryland. That's a different Don Schaefer. Patrick Henry threatens. There is Kevin Toth. And there is the Mira Mesa substitute, Mark Fuller.
Touch it easy. Turn, Joy. Turn, Joy.
And right now, Jason Morrison will take it down the sidelines. Mark Foster gets the ball. Tries to bring it in. Tries to cross. And James Dudley will keep it in bounds to Morrison. Morrison is tripped. Foul called against Patrick Henry. Free kick, Mira Mesa. Continuing the Patrick Henry substitutes, Eric Acheff is a junior midfielder. Ross Murray, who we've seen in the game already, is a forward who is a junior. Bill DeCorus is a senior forward. Naja Lyon is a junior forward, and Eric Smith is a junior defender. Only three sophomores on the roster for Patrick Henry. And Kevin Krasnow is the only starter.
Run by him, run by him!
Long kick again by Stevens. It's headed away by Algie to Travis Northcote.
Stand him up, stand him up!
And there's a... not a trip. It was not called. The referee signals play on. It's out of bounds. Throw in Mira Mesa.
Lose him! Turn!
There is John Madich.
Wait, let's go.
No, it's not.
Go,
it's Nate Dow, number 9. Nope. It is John Madich, number 19. Take that back. John is listed as a forward, but he's playing defense tonight. The substitutes for Mira Mesa are James DeLeon, a junior defender, Travis Northcote, the junior midfielder who is already coming to the game, Brian Davis, a sophomore forward, Nate Dow, a senior defender, Kenny Goss, a sophomore forward, John Millard, a senior midfielder. There's one of the starters, Joey Pellegrino. He's been dangerous all night, so is Mark Foster. And Foster was a little too dangerous there. Dangerous kick called. Possession to Patrick Henry. And it's going to go into the Mira Mesa defense.
One on one. Come up and meet.
But back to Patrick Henry. There is Diego D'Agostino.
Turn, turn and go.
There's Mark Foster. Foster trying to beat D'Agostino. He decoys him. Kicks it off Kevin Toth, and out of bounds, throw in Mira Mesa. The rest of the Marauder substitutes are David Martin, a sophomore defender, Kalani Napoleon, a junior midfielder, Hector Garcia, a junior forward, Chris Vandenhoevel, a sophomore forward, Mark Fuller, the senior forward who we've seen tonight, and James Arndt, a senior midfielder. There is Bronco Madich. It's kicked away. And now taken by Algie. Algie, once again, a long kick. It's headed away by Dustin Jenks.
One guy up, the other guy's rebound.
And now cleared by Patrick Henry. Battle for the ball. Indecisive, but now taken by Patrick Henry again. Down the sidelines, cross, and headed by Vince Ferracci, but saved Josh Quinn. Still a fast-paced game. The clock is ticking off. We played three quarters of the first half. Mira Mesa has a 2-1 lead. They scored less than halfway through the first half. So we've gone almost 15 minutes without a goal, but that doesn't mean anything. We had three goals in just over 11 minutes. Throw in Patrick Henry. To be taken by Tomzevic. It's cleared away by Branko Medic. And now Mark Foster has the ball. Medic. That is cleared by Patrick Henry. That is Juan Larios shooting for the ball. He is foul. Patrick Henry will have a free kick.
Here it goes, Gerald. Here it goes.
Tries to pass to Tomzevic. It's headed away by Daryl Owen. And there's Lee Martin. It'll be taken by Mark Foster. Foster taking the ball back. Trying to get the ball past Toth. He does. After Toth deflects it. Foster down the sidelines.
There goes 15 again.
He's going. He's trying to get it in. It's going to be taken by two Patrick Henry players. And now Mark Fuller has the ball, but a foul is called. Patrick Henry's ball. Just over 7 minutes left in the first half.
Now behind him, don't be side by side.
We've seen three goals and a lot of close calls. Another long kick. Another interception by Daryl Owen. And Stevens is going to get another chance to place the ball.
Get ready, back him up. He's leaving the man right now.
And will he find Leek? No, once again, it's headed away by Owen. And a foul's called.
Come on, guys, get one more right now.
Free kick for the Marauders. Both of these schools, relatively new. Patrick Henry opened in 1967. Mira Mesa opened in 1976.
He's on your back now, he's on.
For Pat Corr, he may have a lot more to worry about than just losing seniors to graduation. Scripps Ranch High School is scheduled to open in the next year or so. So Pat may lose a number of his incoming players to the new high school. But Pat's not worrying about that right now.
Travis, one of you guys on the post with him. One on the post.
Josh!
And the free kick goes into the wall. It's taken again by Patrick Henry. Larios to D'Agostino. To Tomzevic, but offsides. Offsides whistled against the Patriots. Mira Mesa only has four senior starters, so they'll have theoretically seven players returning next year. Seven starters returning next year. Mira Mesa has six sophomores and one freshman on the roster, so Pat Corr will have a lot of talent in the next year or so. When a new high school opens, players, or students rather, at the existing high school are grandfathered. They do not have to go to the school in the new district. So Pat Corr may be able to keep the nucleus of his team. There is Jason Morrison, a junior. Now is Hector Garcia. Hector, one of the substitutes who has come in. Goal kick, Patrick Henry. Just under 4 minutes left in the first half. Unofficial time, that is. The referee keeps the official time. He is not obliged to correct the clock on the scoreboard. And in fact, that clock will be shut off with 3 minutes and a half to play. But the scores will not be shut off. If anybody scores in the last 3 minutes of the half, it will count. Throw in to be taken by D'Agostino. Down the sidelines, and it's kicked away by Daryl Owen. Now, Jenks back to the goalie. And this one is headed by Vince Ferracci. It'll be taken by Algie. Tries to find Pellegrino, goes over Pellegrino's head to Garcia. And it's taken away by Kevin Toth. There is Travis Northcote with the ball into triple coverage. Justin Jenks kicks it away. Northcote and Jenks battling for the ball again. Bill DeCouris for Patrick Henry. And this one will be taken away by John Matic. And now to Branko Matic. That's headed by Branko Matic. And Matic once again. There is Mark Fuller to Garcia to Morrison. Morrison down the sidelines. Morrison still has the ball. Morrison to... No, just over the head of James Dudley. It'll be a goal kick for Patrick Henry. And there is Dudley. He's hobbling. He is down. Dudley is down. He's on his knees. He's off the field, so he can't be out. Oh, he's back up. He's back up, and he will be whistled for offsides. But now he's back down. They're going to call injury time here. They're going to stop the referee's clock, extend the first half, attend to James Dudley, make sure he's all right. He's walking with a little limp. Dudley's coming out. Walking slowly off to the sideline. He sits down, he grabs the bottle, he's still down, he's not getting up.
He takes over.
And that's the end of the first half. The score, Mira Mesa 2, Patrick Henry 1. This is Joe Naiman for George Langevin Productions. We'll be back with the final 40 minutes of regulation time, if not the game, in just a moment. We're back for the second half of the CIF Boys Division I Finals. Mira Mesa currently has a 2-1 lead. And they have the ball. They took the kickoff for the second half. Patrick Henry took the kickoff in the first half. Patrick Henry has 40 minutes to come back, if not take the lead. Patrick Henry desperately trying for its 20th win. The Patriots were 17-2-1 in the regular season. Patrick Henry tends to be a second half team. And Pat Corr knows that he can't let Patrick Henry take advantage of that. There was a lot of action in the first half. Ball was on both halves of the field. Nobody dominated. Mira Mesa got one more goal in. Both goalies made a significant number of saves. They were very impressive. We're not for some good goalkeeping tonight and some good defense. We'd see a lot higher scoring game. George Langevin Productions has been covering the CIF finals for several years now. We don't see too many games like this. We've seen 0-0 ties. We've seen 3-0 wins, but this game is close. It's high action and it's exciting. And if you would like George Marble to do one of your games, you can contact George, or George Langevin rather. He used to be George Marble Productions, now he's George Langevin Productions. There is Mira Mesa clearing the ball. If you want George Langevin Productions to do a game for you, you can call him at 619, area code 549-9952. Or you can write him at 9953 Aviary Drive, San Diego, California, 92131. George has been doing soccer for several years. He also does football, basketball, baseball, hockey, and any other sport you'd like to play or you'd like to have him covered. So give him a call if you're interested. There is Mark Fuller with the ball to Travis Northcote, to John Madich. There's John playing a little bit more of a forward position. You can see he's listed as a defender. He plays defense, but he can be an offensive threat too. In fact, Jason Algie was listed as defender, and from about 30 yards out, he scored the first goal of the game. There's Joey Pellegrino. Ball is taken away. There's Hector Garcia. Garcia is kicked away by Dustin Jenks. And now Kyle Stevens has to fall on the ball, keep it out of the hands of the, or keep it out of the feet of the dangerous Mira Mesa team. Now it's in the feet of the dangerous Patrick Henry squad, but 100 yards from the goal, they're not so dangerous. But with Stevens kicked, they could be, and that's Matt Vega with the ball right now. It's taken away by Jason Morrison. Morrison, it's intercepted by Dustin Jenks. Now, Derek Idelot, or Idelot with the ball, and that's gonna go all the way down to the goalie. Josh Quinn taking his time. He's gonna roll it, and it's gonna go back to the goalie. Quinn's gonna pick it up. He has his choice of distribution methods. He will kick it. It's headed by Grimes. And this one is kicked away by Bill DeCorus. Ross Murray. Tried to make it a score, but there was a goalie in the way. Not a good kick by Quinn, just barely in bounds, kept in bounds by Travis Northcote, but a whistle called. Out of bounds, thrown by Chris Van Hovel. Pat Corr didn't like that linesman call. He felt that it hadn't gone all the way out, but he's not gonna let it stop him. That one's gone all the way out. Throwing Marauders. Substitution Marauders. There's Jason Roofs and Mark Foster coming in for Hector Garcia and Mark Fuller. I mentioned the subs earlier. Both these teams do have depth. We've seen some of the substitutes perform already. We've seen games where substitutes have scored game-winning goals. And there is Peyton Leak. Leak and Murray. Keeney and Patrick Henry feet. And Leak tries to cross it, but it's taken by Josh Quinn. Now Patrick Henry has the ball again. Daryl Owen, high clear attempt. It's headed away, and it's gonna go not to, yes, no, it won't go to Foster, but it won't go to Patrick Henry either. It's out of bounds, Amira Mesa throw in. Algie to take the throw in. Down the sidelines to Foster. Short throw in. Foster tries to find Pellegrino, but Pellegrino had two opponents on him. Stevens with the ball. He's had the ball a lot tonight. Short kick for him. Just short of midfield. It's headed away by Travis Northcote. And Patrick Henry will have a throw in. There's Derek Adelot. Foul's called. So Henry will have possession even further down the field. They'll be able to kick it this time. But into white shirts. They were outmanned in the goal area. Mira Mesa has it. That's Jason Ruffs to Jason Algie. And that is Mark Foster. There are three Jasons starting for Mira Mesa today, tonight. Jason Algie, Jason Morrison, and Jason Ruffs. So don't let yourselves get confused. And that is a foul. Juan Larios tugging on the arm of Michael Grimes. Stan Gutowski, the referee, saw that one. Stan Gutowski's linemen today are Randy Yunt and Brad Branch. There's a header, headed to the goalie by the Patrick Henry team. It's dangerous only if the goalie and the defender break down communication. That's how own goals happen. In the CIF playoffs in Division I, Patrick Henry beat two seeded teams. They face San Diego, who is seeded number 4, in 3-2 game in overtime. They defeated San Diego. Then they played San Diego, who is the top seed. They defeated San Diego 3-2 in overtime and penalty kicks. And now they're playing Mira Mesa. And it is theoretically possible. In fact, they'd have to score a second goal to get back in it, so they could win this one 3-2 in overtime too. Mira Mesa played Hilltop in its first game. They won 2-0. They played Poway in the second game. They won 2-1. Mira Mesa has not played a seed team in the playoffs. Poway upended Bonita Vista in the first round. But Mira Mesa is number 2, and they were number 1 in the Eastern League.
Come on, guys, attack him. Let's go.
There's Jason Algie. Algie to take the free kick. Couple of teammates deep. He will kick it into Patrick Henry feet. It was cleared away. And now D'Agostino has the ball. He slips. Kicked by Mark Foster. But not into the net.
Let's win it.
Goal kick, Patrick Henry. for Mira Mesa coach Pat Kaur. This is a rivalry, but goes a little deeper than that. Pat Kaur graduated from Patrick Henry High School. So Pat has feelings for both teams, but his allegiance is to Mira Mesa. There is Patrick Henry. And Kyle Stevens takes it. Those look threatening, but if Jason Roofs had ever gotten close, too close, Dustin Jennings would have kicked it away. And there is Ross Murray trying to advance it for Henry. It was taken away or blocked by Travis Northcote. Throw in Mira Mesa. We've played 12 minutes in the second half. Mira Mesa has a 2-1 lead. And there's Travis Northcote again. He's being covered by Juan Larios, who takes the ball away. Now Bill DeCorus has it. Tries to pass to Ross Murray. It's picked away by Jason Algie. Foul call, little rough stuff. And now Algie and Murray are being called by the referee. Referee will undoubtedly issue a caution. Yep, caution has been issued to Ross Murray, and Ross will come out. Vince Ferracci in the game. Don Schaefer is going to have a few words with Ross. Second yellow card we've seen tonight. In the event that a player is issued a second yellow card, it is a red card, which means that not only are they out of the game, but their team cannot replace the player. Their team would have to play one man short. And there is Mark Foster. And there is John Madich. There's Jason Morrison. It's kicked away. We're in the second half. We have not slowed down. We don't have a goal yet, but we are still seeing action throughout. Fast-paced game, long passes, a lot of shots, a lot of action on the goalie. And give credit to Kyle Stevens and Josh Quinn that it's only 2-1 right now. Mira Mesa scored first as Algie rebounded a shot from about 30 yards out. He shot it past Kyle Stevens. Less than a minute later, Patrick Henry tied it up on a header by Peyton Lee. And then Joey Pellegrino shot off the right side of the post, right post of the goal into the net. That's where it stands right now. Mira Mesa 2, Patrick Henry 1. And there's a Patrick Henry player down. Wasn't really a rough play, but the field is a bit damp. It rained throughout the weekend. And we're at Torrey Pines High School. We're close to the ocean. We do have some humidity out here. A lot more than, say, the East County All-Star game that was played Monday at El Cajon High School. Of course, El Cajon's was played a lot closer to the end of the rain, so their field was actually wetter, but the field is a factor here. In fact, on the west side of the field, there are some patches of grass that are not in the best condition. Now, Patrick Henry will try to get Vince Ferracci the ball. Ferracci has the ball. But not before it goes out of bounds. Goal kick, Mira Mesa. The Mira Mesa Marauders have a 2-1 lead. You've seen free substitution in and out. I'll try to point out the new players who have come in. Most of the players in right now we've already mentioned. There's Jason Morrison, we've mentioned him a lot, and for good reason. And Mark Foster will kick the ball back to Jason Algie. Algie is tripped. Free kick, Mira Mesa. Algie to take the free kick. Foster was motioning to him as he ran down the sidelines. And up front. Free kick to the side to Daryl Owen. Owen is being covered by Bill DeCoris, and DeCoris will get the best of him, but not before it goes out of bounds. Throw in. And that is a shot and a goal! Travis Northcote gets it under Kyle Stevens at 16 minutes and 7 seconds into the second half. The score, Mira Mesa 3, Patrick Henry 1. The goal by Travis Northcote. Mira Mesa now has a 2-goal lead. Patrick Henry now has a 2-goal deficit. Patrick Henry scored at least 3 goals in 13 of their 23 regular season games. This is the first postseason game in which they've scored 3 goals. They scored at least 4 goals in 8 of those regular season games. There is Josh Quinn with the ball. Back to his in league play, Patrick Henry scored 4 goals against Morse once. They scored 7 goals against Sarah and 4 goals against Sarah. They scored 3 goals against Point Loma. And they had never scored more than 1 goal against Patrick Henry this season until tonight. For Don Schaefer, time is running out. We've played almost halfway through the second half. He's got about 20 minutes to score 2 goals. It has happened. And Peter Tomzovic with the throw-in. Wanted to let it happen there. In fact, Tomzovic will not get the ball. Yes, no, he will not get the ball, but he is fouled, so Patrick Henry will get the ball. Tomzovic will not take the free kick. Lee Martin will take the free kick. And it will be cleared by Mira Mesa, but now it goes to Juan Larios. And that was Vince Ferracci trying to beat a defender. Goes out of bounds, and it'll be a corner kick. Tomzovic take the corner kick. And into traffic, headed over the net. Goal kick near Mesa. And now James Dudley has come back in for Travis Northcote. I said earlier that we've seen substitutes score goals, and Travis Northcote was the first example in the game tonight. In fact, so far he's the only example. But he put it on the ground, but more importantly, he put it past Kyle Stevens. Jason Algy, he scored the first goal of the game. He tried to pass it to Jason Roos, who slipped but retained possession. Roos down the sideline. Mark Foster battling for the ball. Juan Larios battling with him. Patrick Henry will get a goal kick out of it. Goal kick goes to midfield. It's headed by Branko Matic to the sidelines and out of bounds. Throw in Patrick Henry. And it'll be taken by Algy. Foul called. Free kick, Patrick Henry. Dustin Jenks to take the kick. Low and into defense, but nice recovery by Larios. To no avail. Throw in. Algy with the ball. Throw-in attempt is taken by Ferracci, but went out of bounds. Another throw-in, this time a little more upfield. Throws it past midfield. And Michael Grimes was called for obstruction. Dustin Jenks. That kick is blocked. Mark Foster with the block. And now Stan Gutowski is ruling that Foster did not give 10 yards. Foster must give 10 yards. Gutowski is ruling that he charged in. He will be issued a yellow card. Now Foster going to the sidelines. Pat Court, have a few words with him. Nice block, but illegal. And if it's illegal, it doesn't even count. There's Jason Ruffs with the ball. Ruffs to Joey Pellegrino. Pellegrino has one man on him. Now the Patrick Henry defense gets back in. And Pellegrino is down. Pellegrino is down. Josh Quinn with the ball. He's going to hold it. He's going to hold it. He's going to wait till Pellegrino's taken care of. He's went. No. Yeah, he's going to kick it to the sidelines. Kick it out of bounds. He's going to let Patrick Henry have the ball. Now Gutowski's going to attend to Pellegrino. Lifting Pellegrino's leg. Pat Kaur has come out.
come out and then come right back in.
1 minute,
1 minute, 2 minutes.
Pellegrino is walking to the sideline. Gets a big hand from the Mira Mesa crowd. And that'll give Mark Foster a chance to come back in. So a new CIF rule, if you get a yellow card, you do have to come out. You can come back in at the next substitution opportunity. So you don't have to stay out too long. That gives the players time to cool down. We had one famous instance of a red card in the CIF final. The Monta Vista goalie was kicked in the head. The offending player was given a red card. In the second overtime, the Bonita Vista team did score the final goal against the Monta Vista goalie, who played the second overtime, came off the field, and promptly passed out. And that goalie was Tyler Adamson, who played with Cuyamaca College. Tyler did well for Cuyamaca. He will be going on to four-year play if he can make the squad. In fact, Tyler Adamson was injured on this very field. Bonita Vista's girls lost in the girls' final tonight. San Dieguito defeated them on 3 second-half goals. Ron Pietola, it was his second loss in the finals in 3 years. But Pietola does have a CIF championship under his belt. He defeated Poway in 1986. Neither of these coaches have a CIF championship. In fact, neither of them has reached the CIF final prior to tonight. There's Mira Mesa trying to clear it. They do clear it. And now back to Patrick Henry. And it looks like James Dudley will be whistled for dangerous play. That's headed away. Patrick Henry with the ball. They're trying for their second goal. They need two to tie. Time is running out. There's less than 15 minutes left in the game. Mira Mesa has a 3-1 lead, and that ball will go out of bounds. Mira Mesa will have possession of the ball. For Mira Mesa now, it's a matter of running out the clock. Yes, they'd like to get that fourth goal just as insurance, but their main objective right now is to keep Patrick Henry from scoring their second. For Patrick Henry, scoring that second goal is a must. It's a prerequisite to scoring the third. And there is Foster. Foster to Michael Grimes. Grimes has two defenders on him. He will not take possession of the ball, but it's going to go out of bounds. He'll have a throw-in.
Let's go. Push up on him.
Grimes will take the throw-in.
Jason. Jason. You can go up here. We got two on him already.
And attempt two. Mark Fuller. The kick is just off. Goal kick, Patrick Henry. These two teams have both played aggressive soccer tonight. There is Mark Foster again to Jason Ruff's butt offsides. Kyle Stevens, we've seen his long kicks all through the night. And there's another one. Stevens' biggest deficiency tonight is that his high kicks are being fielded by taller Mira Mesa opponents. Stevens has not done a bad job. He's allowed 3 goals, but he's saved many more. Mira Mesa has just been on the goal all night. Here's Mark Foster, here's Mark Fuller. Patrick Henry defense is not getting a rest, nor is it likely that they will throughout the game. Substitutions are the only way that any player can rest. Here's an offside, but it's not offside, it's called advantage instead. Goes to the goalie. There's no use depriving Stevens of a punt by giving an offsides ruling at that point. Henry throw in, just over 11 minutes left. Cleared away by Dudley. And Ruff's tried to keep it in, but not successful. Derek Adelot with a throw-in for Patrick Henry. And there's Jason Ruff. There's Ruff trying to take it down, and it's going to be taken by Justin Jenks. Jenks will take it back to that goalie. Good strategy, but maybe not considering the time. They've got just over 10 minutes left. For Patrick Henry, that clock becomes very important right now. There's Kevin Toth. Toth down the sidelines, or passes it to the sidelines. There's Ross Murray. And Patrick Henry's going to maintain possession. They'll have a throw-in. Thrown to be taken by Tomzevic. Tomzevic throw-in, long throw-in into the mouth of the goal. Who's going to head it away? Mark Fuller headed away. It's a good thing for Mira Mesa that he did get the header. And now Mark Foster has the ball. Foster has beaten his defense. Pass to Ruff. And just wide. And now Jason Ruff is down. He's going to get up, though. On the counterattack, Mira Mesa almost scored their 4th goal of the night. We've had some stoppage for injury, some for yellow cards, so this game will include injury time. The scoreboard clock does stop for these factors, however, the referee is keeping the official time. Dan Gutowski has been running up and down the field all night. You think it's tough on these two teams. Dan Gutowski is the one who has to be in position for 80 minutes. There's a shot off the post. Lucky break for Patrick Henry, or unlucky for Mira Mesa, depending on your perspective. Patrick Henry could use some lucky breaks right now. They trail by 2 goals.
In the area,
there's
in the
a
area.
High clear. It bounces and it's cleared away by Patrick Henry, but out of bounds, Mira Mesa ball. Come on, come on. This is the fifth year that some finals have been played at Torrey Pines High School. For various reasons, there have been multiple sites in some of the past years. This year we saw three different sites, and we had several games postponed because of the rain, including this game. This game was postponed twice. Well, here it is. We've waited 5 days for the game, and we haven't been disappointed. It's well worth the wait. Mira Mesa with a 3-1 lead. Patrick Henry with the ball on the foul call. They'll have a free kick. Less than 7 minutes remain in the game. Free kick to be taken by Adelot. To the left, headed by Dustin Jenks, and out of bounds. Goal kick, Mira Mesa. Both teams seeing a lot of action. There's Joey Pellegrino coming back in for Mira Mesa. Getting a big cheer. Pellegrino went down. Didn't look that great when he walked off the field, but he's back now. He's healthy, and that's what counts. Pellegrino's played an important part of the game. He has a goal and an assist. There's a battle in the Mira Mesa defensive area. We've seen four goals tonight, three of them by Mira Mesa, only one by Patrick Henry. They've got a little over 5 minutes to score two goals. And Mira Mesa has the ball. The clock is running down. Mira Mesa will undoubtedly keep possession of the ball until less than 5 minutes remain on the clock. Josh Quinn taking his time. Throws it out to Jason Algie. Algie down the sidelines to Dudley. And now to Ruffs, but it's out of bounds. Patrick Henry will have the ball. Sideline pass to Kevin Tough. And it'll be taken by Mira Mesa to Jason Roofs. Roofs to Fuller. Fuller takes it. It's a goal. At 75-43, Jason Ruffs passed to Mark Fuller. Fuller, the second substitute of the game, to score for Mira Mesa. The score now 4-1, Mira Mesa. A good strategy by Patrick Henry. They have to pull up now. They have to have offense. They had to sacrifice their defense. Nobody was really to blame there. Mira Mesa now has a 3-goal lead. There are less than 4 minutes to play. Looks doubtful for Patrick Henry. Cosmira Mesa scored 5 goals in a game. Yes, they have. They scored 5 against University High School. They scored 7 against Sarah. And they've scored 4 against a very good Patrick Henry team. Patrick Henry was trying for its 20th win tonight. They will not get it. They will finish 19-3-1. Not a disrespectful record. They'll be in second place. And second is a lot better than not even making the playoffs at all. They beat the top-seeded team in the semifinals. They beat a seeded team in the first round. They have nothing of which to be ashamed. They played well. They just faced a team that deserves to be the top team in CIF Division 1A. And they're still fighting. That is Peter Tomzevic. They have not given up. They will not give up. They will try for that second goal. They're in it to the end. The clock has been stopped. There are less than 3 minutes to go. Only the referee knows the official time. It's been a well-played game. It was an exciting first half. It's been an exciting second half. The outcome is no longer uncertain. Almost surely, Mira Mesa will have the victory. But both teams have played exceptionally well tonight. The look of despair on the Patriots' faces. Underlies the score. Mira Mesa has 4 goals, Patrick Henry has 1. But Patrick Henry has the ball right now. Lee Martin coming down. Foul call against Mira Mesa. They're not slacking off. There's Justin Danks. He's been a factor throughout. He's been a defensive factor. He's tried to be an offensive factor, although without a lot of luck. We're still seeing ball on both sides of the field. And now Patrick Henry has the ball once again. This is Kevin Toth. Toth tries to get it through, but it's going to go to the goalie instead. Jason Quinn taking as much time as he can. Long kick. Taken by Larios. And now headers by Mira Mesa. And there is James Arndt. He has just come into the game. And there is Kevin Toth. Foul called. Stan Gutowski can blow the whistle anytime now. He's looking at his watch. Free kick to be taken by Adelot. And it's taken away by Mira Mesa. Pellegrino and a foul has been called against Mira Mesa. Free kick, Peyton Leek lines up. He will take it to Kevin Toth. Toth tries to get around his defenders. It's cleared away. John Madich clears the ball away. Time is running down. Throw in. Or corner kick, rather, for Patrick Henry. Henry still with the ball, and that's the final whistle. Mira Mesa has won the 1992 CIF Boys Division I Championship. The final score, Mira Mesa 4, Patrick Henry 1. This is Joe Neiman for George Lansman Productions. We'll be back with a final note very shortly.
gentlemen. Nice game. Nice game.
Congratulations. Good game.
Good game. Nice game, Henry. Nice game, Henry.
Henry, let's get over here, boys. Come on now.
Yeah! Super job. Super job.
Win, baby. Let's see.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, boy.
So once again, the final score, Mira Mesa 4, Patrick Henry 1. A recap of tonight's game. At 6:47, Jason Algie took a rebound of a shot by Joey Pellegrino and put it into the net for the first goal to give Mira Mesa a 1-0 lead. Less than a minute later, at 7:16, in fact, 29 seconds later, a midfield pass from Dustin Jenks was taken by Peyton Leake and put into the net to tie the game up. At 17:34, Algie had the assist this time. He passed it to Joey Pellegrino. Pellegrino's shot went off the right post and into the net. The next score came midway in the second half at 56:07, where Travis Northcote, unassisted, shot the ball on the ground and underneath the goalie. And finally, with less than 5 minutes to play at 75:43, Jason Ruffs pass to Mark Fuller for Mira Mesa's fourth goal of the night. That's the final score. Mira Mesa 4, Patrick Henry 1. We hope you've enjoyed tonight's game. We hope to have you view one of George Langevin's future productions. Once again, this is Joe Naiman for George Langevin Productions.
Touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. Break it down. Stop. Have a time.